Throughout evolutionary history, fish made the transition onto land. They traded in their gills for lungs and gave rise to the amphibians and the reptiles that would ultimately give rise to the mammals like us. And then at some point, us land mammals decided to hop back into the water. And these aquatic marine mammals, like dolphins and whales and seals and sea lions, became masters at taking really deep dives to hunt their fish. Some of the common marine mammals, like the gray and harbor seals that we have right here at the Aquarium of Niagara, can actually stay underwater for upwards of 30 minutes at a time. Certainly a lot longer than you and I can, for about a minute or so. So if they are mammals, just like you and I are, and they have lungs and breathe oxygen from the air, like you and me, how are they able to take such deep dives and stay underwater? It appears that the secret to this marine mammalian superpower has been elucidated by some scientists at the University of Liverpool. All of us land mammals use a special protein in our muscles called myoglobin that binds oxygen and kind of holds onto it as an oxygen reserve for us, so that when we go under the water or we have our access to atmospheric oxygen cut off, our muscle tissues can release some of that myoglobin-carrying oxygen to deliver it to parts of our body as needed. This oxygen-binding myoglobin protein is actually what gives our muscle tissue its red color to make red meat. But there is a limit onto how much myoglobin we can have safely stored in our muscle tissue. If you start storing too much myoglobin and packing it together, it could actually clump together, forming protein aggregates. And when proteins clump together, that tends to be the grounds for really bad diseases to occur. Alzheimer's, for example, is a protein misfolding disease where misfolded tau proteins clump together and form these plaques inside of the brains of individuals. But scientists looking to understand how these marine mammals were able to stay under the water for such a long period of time discovered that their myoglobin was a little bit different than that of us here on land. What they found was that the myoglobin proteins of hundreds of marine mammals, including seals, actually had a stronger positive charge on it than ours does. And this electrical charge actually is the secret to these marine mammals' success. It works through a process known as electrorepulsion, and it's actually a very basic science concept that you are probably familiar with from school. If you have two charges that are alike, a positive charge and another positive charge, they're going to repel one another. Opposite charges attract, like charges repel. It works in kind of the same fashion as magnets. And because these positively charged myoglobin proteins are going to repel one another, you actually have an advantage. In these marine mammals, they can store up to 10 times the amount of positively charged myoglobin proteins and pack it into their muscle tissue, and those positive charges that are causing electrorepulsion are going to prevent their myoglobin proteins from clumping together. So, marine mammals get to hold way more myoglobin than we can without the worry of developing any kind of catastrophic diseases. And then all of that extra myoglobin will actually hold way more oxygen inside the muscle tissue of these animals to act as a larger reserve tank for them so that they can stay cut off from their atmospheric oxygen supply for a longer period of time. And hey, in this era of CRISPR technology and gene engineering and crazy scientists trying to create these superhumans, how cool would it be if you could genetically engineer a human to have this positively charged myoglobin protein so that they could be their own Aquaman, taking these deep dives with the other animals of the ocean? That'd be pretty cool. Thank you guys for watching, and stay inquisitive. Bye, guys.